The Braves make a statement tonight at Doran Park, taking down the first-place Yarmouth Dennis Red Sox by a final of 10-3. Welcome into a post-game Tomahawk Talk. Calvin Christoforo, Reeves Jackson, and Daniel Coates. And Daniel, we've said it all season long how the hitting for this Braves team has been so good on the road. But here at Doran Park, we haven't seen it yet.
Right.
Tonight, we saw it in full display. 10 runs on 15 hits. What do you think was the biggest factor in the Braves' success at the plate?
I think it was the way that they were able to string it together. You know,
yeah.
Innings where you put up 3 runs, 4 runs. That's what's really going to put you far and away above other teams. I actually am surprised that they only got 10 runs on 15 yeah. hits. I'm so surprised, too, that we didn't see the deep ball with 10 runs being posted. But, again, full performance from the entire lineup. And it's just really cool to see, you know, guys like Nick Goodwin and Colby yeah. Thomas continuing to produce and Dalton Rushing just raking out here. So really good performance from everyone. And when you put up 15 hits, it's really hard to beat. And I know Reeves will probably talk a little bit about the pitching, but 15 hits, that is astounding. 10 runs, and we pretty much walked away from this from the get-go.
Yeah, the Braves offense was stellar tonight. You mentioned Nick Goodwin, 3-for-5 night for him. Dalton Rushing, 4-for-5 night. But let's go to the pitching staff here tonight, Reeves. And this Braves pitching staff has been great all year. We've said it, right? Gordon Graceffo, Nick Zwack down the line. But right now, there is nobody on this team, and there is nobody on the Cape pitching better than Tristan Grealing. 4 innings of perfect baseball tonight. Coming off a performance on the 4th of July where he threw 3 scoreless innings, the guy is dominating right now.
Yeah, it's dating back to it now, obviously. That's 21 batters in a row that Tristan Grealing has set down. 3 perfect innings at Wareham at Spillane on the 4th of July, and tonight 4 perfect innings.
Well, it's going to be 22, right? At least in the lab outing before that.
Yeah, exactly. No, you're right. You're right. That's true. That's true. Dating back to the last 2, but yeah, going back further, absolutely. There's definitely got to be more, but he's incredible right now. I literally, he's so shut down right now, and I was joking with Daniel, and we were joking together. He's keeping Joe Lampley busy out there in center. 5 of his 12 outs were fly balls to center tonight.
I said he had to have been responsible for 33% of the fielding out there. Joe Lampley was on his toes the entire night. And I'd rather have no one else than Joe Lampley who's that fast, and he showed it on the base path tonight.
Yeah, but obviously you talked about some of your sideline hits. One of your sideline hits tonight, obviously you talked about some pitchers that could potentially step up in the wake of losing Zwack and Van Loon and Graceffo. And obviously, Grealing is a guy who could potentially get a spot start, obviously, and get some starts. We saw Parsley in this first start tonight. So it'll be interesting to see how these pitchers are used, as now Kane Smith, who was unlucky as all get out in that 9th inning, will be used as a back-end guy for the Braves.
Yeah, Austin Parsley got the start tonight. I actually thought it was going to be Tristan Grealing's night because he kind of piggybacked off Gordon Graceffo. I thought they were preparing him to slide in. But Tristan Grealing stays out of the bullpen and stays excellent. Probably the best all-around win this season. I think that's fair to say. The offense goes for 15 hits. The pitching gives up 3, and the Braves win by 7 runs. A 10-3 final here at Doran Park. Up next for the Bravos is a trip out east at Veterans Field and the Chatham Anglers tomorrow at 7. But you can join us, as always, at 6:40 for the Bravos, our Braves pregame show. Until then, go Braves.